Adi. Adi.
Secretary, we shall have Madame Salma as the winner. Yes. Second Vice President, yes. Madame Salma wins. Then we have for the Treasurer, Odong Joseph. Odong Joseph wins. He becomes our next Treasurer, please. Then we shall have our first Vice President as Ahmed K. Abdallah. Of UVF to have a word or two to share with us to do and how he expects to do it. Thank you.
Thank you very much, the Electoral Commission. We, the new executive and board, we are delighted and happy the transparency of how this exercise has gone. We have just been announced as the new executive and board of the Federation, and we are going to start our work today. We are going to plan how to start the league. Very important. We are going to start our league. We have a girls' team training down there. We are going to host that qualifier here in Kampala. We are taking up this challenge because we know it is our challenge, and we have been thinking about it, that as soon as we come into office, as we are going to take up that mantle and host this event. I want to take this opportunity to thank my board and executive. Congratulations. I'm happy that I'm going to work with you. The expectation is high for those people who have been here. We need to make sure we deliver. We deliver in what we have promised, and some of us have done it before. The overwhelming votes we have received, some of us, because I remember I got more than 200 votes, clearly shows the confidence the delegates have in us. When we even out of the system, we can get that concrete and robust election. I want to thank the press for covering this event. And please know that volleyball is transparent. I think we have tried to show how transparent we are. And coming up with this is a clear manifestation of how robust our constitution and our systems operate. I won't stop here because we have a lot. We have been almost 3 months non-sleep looking for votes, and we are happy we are in this. We shall be convening soon as the new elect. Make sure we fill our executive and board. Some of these positions are technical and they are for appointment. Thank you. Thank you for being with us. I think the General Secretary wants to say something.
The newly elected President. To begin with, I want to thank everybody who has stand up for this very important day and function when we came here to witness volleyball making a decision. We want to say that volleyball has decided and we accept the decision. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the electoral body that has been handling this exercise. We want to thank you so much. It was not an easy exercise, but finally we have come to its conclusion. Thank you for the job well done. I also want to thank all those who volunteered to serve of volleyball. Yes, that is the sport, and we cannot forget that volleyball, unlike other sports, we work in odd numbers. And when we work in odd numbers, it means we shall always have one on top of the other. So we had to have some people winning. And of course, when you win, there should be those who have won. So we want to congratulate you for having accepted to present yourselves. But that's what the people have decided. Accept their decisions. In the same vein, I want to congratulate all those who have been successful for the offices they vied for. Congratulations for turning up winners. You have won the offices, but the sport has won generally. I want to inform members that yes, we are here to serve the sport. Volleyball is bigger than any of us. There's nobody who is bigger than the sport of volleyball here. You may think you like it. Yes, that is true. But the sport is still bigger than any of us. And the other one is that for us, we come and serve for just a whole short time. But volleyball will be there forever. We cannot live the time volleyball will live. We only serve and live. We must accept this. Having said that, I want to say these words. Those of you who have taken up offices, you offered yourselves to serve the sport, please serve. That is my one. You offered to serve, please serve. The other word is not good. If you are not ready to serve, if you are not ready to serve, tell us now, before these people leave. If you are not ready, you either serve or leave. But since you are not coming up, be ready to serve. Next, what you have asked for is a sacrifice. Don't think you are going to sit and just sit and sit and sit. You have come to sacrifice to serve. And I know very well that when you are seeking for the votes, you told people you have come to volunteer. I want you to take note of that word. You have come to offer voluntary service. Don't expect any form of payment for the office you are holding. You've come to serve voluntarily. Nobody forced you to pick nomination papers. Next, the offices you have got call for a lot of commitment. Get committed and serve the sport. In addition, it calls for dedication. Again, it is also going to encroach on your time. Please find time for volleyball. We can only drop this sport if we devote part of our time to the sport. I have seen a number of things happening here. As council, we have taken note of this. And when we come to observe, we don't just sit in chairs and see, but there are particular things we look at. I know soon you'll be coming to our offices to ask for this and the other. We are saying your actions will determine the course of our actions. What you do determines how we act and react. So you need to be very careful. And on a very, 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 very serious note, this one is very serious. And I want you to take it. One of your
one of your undoing is your supreme law. I've looked at your supreme law, which you call your constitution. Your constitution requires, is in a very, very sorry state. It requires comprehensive surgery. Comprehensive surgery. You need to address yourself to your constitution. It almost caused you problems here.
I think the mic is back.
It's back. So you need to pay attention to your constitution. It is mixed up. You mixed up articles of the constitutions with the regulations. You need to differentiate these two. Regulations should stand as regulations, and they are not part of the constitution. So we have noted, and we think you will take care of this. That constitution does not befit the status of the sport of volleyball we have in this country. So you need to address yourself to that. Having said all this, I want to wish you the best and look forward to you elevating the level of volleyball in this country. God bless you.
It's supposed to be prayer.
Yeah, we are, after the election, we are looking at starting our league. Our league and our sport, the game has not been there, and the other sports have already started their competitions. We need to speed track us going back on court. The other thing is we have under 20, the ladies, the girls, and we are hosting next month. We want to make sure that we take up that responsibility and we host that event here in Kampala. The other thing is just cleaning up the house. We need to make sure that we fill up the positions which are technical in nature, and the many commissions, and from there we shall handle this handover of other events from the outgoing executive and the board.
In the next 4 years, what should the stakeholders of volleyball expect from you, the president, and the executive?
The expectation is we want to take back the volleyball to the grassroots. That is something we have all agreed. We also want to make sure that we train our technical people. We want to make sure that we start the game, like now it has stopped. We want to make sure that there is competition at local level, regional and continental. And we want also to develop our technical people. On top of that one, we have to go out as a president and my presidents to look for resources for this game. This game cannot move when we are not, our resource envelope is hanging. We need money. We need money to make sure that we move most of our events around here. That is the biggest we are looking at.
Well, there have been a number of divisions and risks between the different stakeholders, Uganda Volleyball Federation. Don't you think if probably the sport is to move on where you want it to go again, everybody will need to come on board and you all pull in one direction?
Looking at the results I've gathered as a president, 200 plus votes, I believe we are together with most people whom we defied our thinking. And that alone for me gives me that impression that many have ganged behind me. Obviously, we shall have one or two, three people who might have a different opinion, but we are going to listen to them, and where possible, we shall take time to explain to them where we differ in that particular area.
During the launch of your manifesto, you did talk about reconciliation because you thought probably it was one of the reasons the sport was deteriorating. Is it also an area?
Reconciliation during my campaigns, I've reconciled with guys. People actually, if you look at my result, clearly there is a reconciliation element in it, whereby most people have really come behind me. Obviously, you cannot bring everybody behind you, but that alone clearly shows you that you have made a reconciliation. But those ones whom I haven't reached, because some of them have been in different camps, I'm going to reach to them, and I'm going to make sure we become one. Now it is volleyball. Now it is no longer Sadiq, it is no longer Okila, it is no longer Hadija, it is volleyball. And even me, that's what I'm looking at. We are going to make sure we reconcile for the sake of the game.
Thank you very much.